Clouds are pretty great. They're big, they're puffy, they're beautiful. They make for great time lapses. But to climate scientists, clouds are really, really, really confusing. Even though clouds are right above us all the time, it's difficult to predict their behavior. Depending on the type of cloud, they can cool the climate by reflecting light or warm the climate by trapping in heat. And it's tough to predict how a warming climate will affect their behavior. The definitive scientific body on climate change says clouds are the largest source of uncertainty among climate change prediction models. And that's kind of a big deal, because a little change in clouds goes a long way for the climate. Figuring out what's up with clouds would tell us a lot more about how serious climate change impacts might be. We've got a lot of records about clouds, though. Since the 1980s, we've been monitoring them closely as we record weather patterns across the globe. So, can we use that satellite data and correct for artificial errors to make better predictions? That's what an atmospheric scientist at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography set out to do. Joel Norris and his team studied the satellite record looking for local changes, specific regions that have gained or lost clouds. The goal? To test out a few big predictions climate scientists have been making about clouds. First, there's a lot of concerns that a warmer atmosphere will draw more clouds to the poles, which means that the deserts and dry areas in the subtropics could get even bigger and drier as they see less cloud cover. The second big concern is that climate change will make cloud tops higher, trapping in more heat in the atmosphere and contributing to even more global warming. When the team lined up the climate models with the true satellite record, they found these weren't just predictions. They've been happening since at least the 1980s.
I think we have a tendency often to think of climate change as something that will happen in the future. We see in a satellite record, like, clouds are changing right now. They're already changing.
All of this means that some of the hottest, driest places in the world, regions like California and the Southwest, Australia, Northern Africa, and the Middle East, are likely going to get hotter and drier. That means more droughts, fewer crops, and higher chances of conflict or war. These are just two trends, though, and there's many more ways clouds could change with the climate. You know, Joni Mitchell once said, "I really don't know clouds." And I gotta say, Joni, the scientific community and I kind of agree. One thing we do know for sure is that the climate is changing, and we've got to figure out how that's gonna change our skyscape.